now, we ask right now that you send a special, special, special blessing right now to her son, right now. Touch him right now, Father. He's been going through something, Father.
I have supported my family. That, you know, my daughter's death brought our family close, you know, and if anything I need, you know, I get help, you know, because I'm struggling. Now I got to take care of her son. He have his moments, you know, and I try to understand because he lashes out and I already know where it's coming from. You know, he missed his mom and stuff. And so now, the day she turned 31, we got to go talk to her at the grave site. And that's not good for nobody.
I just want to say to whom responsible for this, what happened to the restrictions? If you're going to do this game banging or whatever, that's the choice you chose, but not to take an innocent person's life. I mean, it's kids can't go to the park now. People scared to go to church. Stop the violence. Break the silence is all I'm asking. Stop the violence, break the silence, because this hurt.
Our calls, it's like I'm getting on the detective's nerves. You know, if I had money, maybe people would talk, but I don't have money. But what's happened in Englewood area, it's like nothing. And my daughter was somebody to me, to her family. So I'm not going to let this lie down. I'm not going to let it go because I want justice for my daughter.